I'm from Sudan, originally from Sudan. I came to the UK in 2007.
Yeah.
Married and I've got 4 children.
You were married when you came here?
Yeah.
Yeah. You have 4 children?
Yeah. 2 boys and 2 girls.
Yeah.
I came as a refugee to this country. It took me about 2 years to get my refugee status. The reason which I came here and asked for asylum is for political reasons.
So political asylum? Yeah. Okay.
Yes. I was graduated from University of Khartoum.
What did you graduate in?
University of Khartoum, I studied law.
Law? Okay, so you have a law degree?
Yeah, got a law degree. And I practiced law as an advocate, sport advocate in my country.
Yeah.
And sport solicitor here.
Yeah.
It's about more than 10 years, 12 years. Since I came to the UK, I involved myself in many voluntary work.
Tell us a little bit about voluntary work at the time.
Right, okay. So I started my voluntary work with my community, which is the Sudanese community.
Is that here in Bolton?
Yeah, it's in Bolton. I was a secretary of the Sudanese Committee in Bolton for more than 2 years. And then I was volunteering with the Refugee Action. Refugee Action, which is a very big organization which is dealing with asylum seekers and refugees. I worked for them more than 2 years as well. I volunteer as it's called, my role is like called advocate volunteer.
So you're effectively an advocate for the people who are seeking asylum?
Yeah. So I was like helping the newcomers, the people who came recently to Bolton.
Yeah.
I used to help them, like in, for example, someone need help to go to the GP, to register to the GP, schools, and
so effectively, you were teaching them the things they needed to know to live in the community in the United Kingdom.
Yeah, and also use my skills like bilingual. Personally, I speak Arabic.
Yeah.
So I use the people who speak Arabic now, who still struggle with the language and this stuff.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Then I work. Really use different voluntary jobs like with the UCAN Center for Farmers, UCAN Center. Yeah. I volunteer like as a mediator with the mediation office in Bolton.
Yeah.
And then like I really feel the community is my community is really need me and need help because it's a growing community. Sudanese community is really growing community, and the people struggle with many issues, especially the women.
So particularly the women, you feel have.
Yeah. They got like many issues which they struggle with their man. Then me and my. Some of my friends from Sudanese community.
Mm.
We think about founding a group, a community group, especially women.
So you're planning?
Yeah.
Is this specifically for the Sudanese community?
No, it's not especially for that community. It's for every woman which is affected. It's The group which we found is called E Swimming Group, E-A-E-S-E. Yeah, which stands for engagement, awareness, support, and entertainment.
Yeah.
This group is found about 2 years ago.
Okay.
And it's really concerned about women affected with female genital mutilation. So this group is found, and we really found support from many, many organizations.
Yeah.
Like Bolton at Home, like Band, like, and they really supported us, and the CVS, Bolton CVS. Yeah. And we really, in these 2 years, we achieved many, many, many things, and many to support the ladies which are affected by this problem, and we managed to raise awareness about female genital mutilation.
Is this a fairly significant problem in this area? It's a major problem, is it? FGM?
Sorry?
Is FGM quite a big problem?
Yeah, a very, very, very big problem. It's really a sad story which affected the women. The women affected with this problem, they need support, they need, and we as well need to protect the young generation, the young people from being affected with female genital mutilation. And we need to raise awareness, we need to help the ladies, especially at the hospitals, because people struggle and nobody knows about this problem. And so we really achieved many things, and we managed to help them and raise awareness about female gender mutilation in Bolton.
Mm.
And we work in partnership with other organizations. Yeah.
All right, lovely, thank you. How do you feel about being nominated for this award?
It's really, really good. I was surprised when I found I've nobody that I really have who nominated me to this.
So you don't know anyone?
No.
No. Okay. But you're pleased to have been nominated.
Very pleased. Yeah.
Now clearly you're involved in a lot of community work. How important do you feel it is for women, young girls, to have role models, people in the community that they
it's
can turn
very
to.
Important. Yeah. It's very important, really, and especially for the new communities, for the ethnic minorities from the community which I came from. Sudanese community is really very important. For example, people who feel like still not integrated, still not like feel isolated. And sometimes they still need to feel like confident, and they need to trust the community which they.
So they need to have somebody that they trust, that they can turn to help.
Yeah. It's really very good, and it's really very brilliant idea, and it's make the people feel confident. They make them trust the community, and they feel integrated and feel belong. Yeah.
Do you have a message for other women, about getting involved in community, volunteering in the community and helping others, particularly as in your case, in helping people who've just come to this country to integrate into the community?
Yeah.
Do you have a message?
Yes. I think of my message, when I started my volunteering, because when I came here, I struggle with many things, and I feel myself struggling with many issues, like still not fully confident of being like going to have volunteering or to speak in public or to still feel myself struggling with the language, not fluently speaking. But my message is that don't feel yourself less than being involved and less than go everywhere and feel integrated. And every time I told my you know, the ladies which I work, and they always said that we still not confident, we still not feel that we are can speak to the people and talk to them, and we have many, many barriers. We got the big barrier, which is the language barrier. But I told them, go everywhere and go and feel, if you want to do anything, just go and do it. Don't be like shy, don't be feel that, no, I'm not confident, I can't do it, I can't.
Just go ahead.
Yeah, so in my message is to encourage the people, to encourage especially the ladies to go and every time they can feel that sometimes they can't go and do anything. They have to do volunteering, they have to integrate, they have to do their role. It's not just about sitting at home and just taking care of the babies or they can do many, many things. So this is my message, really.
Lovely. Thank you. And just lastly, I mean, you have been nominated for this award. Is there anybody you can think of that you would nominate if you were given the opportunity to nominate somebody for this particular award?
Yeah, I'm really thinking of many, many people.
There are many people.
Yeah.
So there's no particular person that you would like to?
I've got in my mind a particular lady. She's a young lady. And she's really very good, having got that detail, really. Yeah. But I'm really thinking of her. Her name is Crystal. Crystal. Do you know Crystal Nigma? Yeah, I can forward her detail. But she's really very good. I like her. She's very, very, very. She has done many volunteering work, and I know she's enough for this.